Hey gearheads, and welcome to Garage Talk. I'm Corey, and behind me here is the entry-level brand new Ford F-150 Lightning, which from the outside looks like a normal F-150 until you pop the hood to discover there's no engine in this vehicle. And in this video, I will take you on a quick tour of this one, a quick drive of this one, and two higher trims to see what all the hubbub is about with America's number one selling vehicle going all electric. Stay tuned. So starting under the hood, you actually have a power operated, even here on this base pro trim, power operated frunk that is very utilitarian and can be used for many different things. You can see there's a ruler in here for measuring, tells you your weight limits, and then you do get an adjustable cargo divider here that can actually stand up in place and divide for the cargo. There's your standard charger that comes with the vehicle. And then popping that down into place, you even get your Pro Power on board here. So you can have a front tailgate if you want. So very cool features up here in the front. A lot of work went into making this a usable space. It's not like they just removed the engine and made this truck. A lot of engineering work actually went in to making this work, just like a tailgate on any SUV or family vehicle of the like. And you see, power operated. Now you've got this hard plastic here on this pro trim. You get some nicer materials on top trims, and this LED light bar does not continue all the way across. Moving over to the side, it looks just like any regular F-150 really, but you do get your charge panel up here that allows for charging at home or DC fast charging with your charge indicator. Very nifty, handy there as well. This is the base pro trim, so you get vinyl seats, just a normal roof up there, no folding workstation here, but you do interestingly get the folding gear selector, so not sure why that's there. Very nice, very up to date. You still get a color screen up here, 77% charge, and you get the horizontal screen, which I actually prefer over the top trims, and then a vinyl floor. So this really is meant to be a work truck and is an incredible value. As this one sits, it is $56,000, which to get a gas-powered F-150 is quite a bargain as well. So yeah, very, very nice truck all the way around. And you can see we've got a standard bed in this one. This one does have the spray and bed liner because, you know, Ford does have the aluminum beds. So take that as you will. But why don't we hop behind the wheel of this one and see how it drives. All right, so here we are setting off in the Ford F-150 Lightning in the Pro Trim. This is a media event. I do have Adam from Texas Truck Channel. Look at what I'm doing. We were just talking about those guys, but TX Garage. So go check out his stuff from this same event. Yeah, we are driving around three different trim levels of the F-150 Lightning today. And starting off here for you in the base model Pro Trim. Now, I did say in the intro, this does start at $39,995, whatever, $40,000. This particular model is $56,000, and most of that is because, well, it's got the dual motor powertrain for 10 grand, and oh my goodness, makes a big difference. It also comes with the extended battery. So that 10 grand is well spent in the fun factor, in the four wheel drive, and makes this a very usable family rig as well. Speaking of that, this is the family vehicle of Texas in a full size pickup truck because they are everywhere down here. And this, the F-150 is America's number one selling vehicle. So when the F-150 goes electric, it's kind of a big deal and has caused quite a stir. The fact that you can get in the door of one for $40,000, which is not a bad place to be, is not a bad thing whatsoever. And it actually rivals some of the gas-powered variants of this truck, because I've got a large 12-inch horizontal color touchscreen up here. I still have a digital gauge cluster in front of me. This does not feel like a base model truck, and when you put the pedal down, it definitely does not go like any truck that you've ever driven. This one, currently, let's see what drive mode we are in. We're in normal, so that little acceleration wasn't even in all-out sport. So I'll put it in sport, but we're hitting downtown Grapevine with, looks like, some train traffic in front of me, which allows me to talk about another feature here on the screen in the one-pedal drive. So this actually allows you to drive the vehicle with one foot, essentially. And I came to a complete stop by lifting my foot off the accelerator. Can't call it the gas because there's no gas, but does a really good job of slowing you to a stop. I will say, because my dad always asks me when I talk about this feature, you can actually still use the brakes. And it does take a little learning to get used to the one pedal drive. But when you do, it's a feature I've actually really come to enjoy because it just makes stop and go traffic so nice, convenient, and easy. So while we're stopped here waiting on the train, I can talk about, it is definitely a work truck. You don't get a leather wrapped steering wheel, you don't get the folding workspace, but you do still get a USB-A, USB-C up here. You still get, it looks like, dual zone climate controls. So it's not a Spartan interior by any means. It's just no Lariat or Platinum or top trims, which we'll get to those in just a minute, but still a very comfortable ride. And that is perhaps the most surprising thing of hopping in these F-150 Lightnings, is how comfortable they really are. We just drove over railroad tracks. We're driving over brick pavement. This thing rides so incredibly well that I am genuinely impressed in how it handles all sorts of pavement. And yeah, I'm still getting used to the one pedal drive, but very, very impressive total package. And everybody wants to focus on the range or the acceleration or you name one single feature, but when you take this vehicle in its entirety, it's $39,000 starting price. The fact that at 77% charge, I have 270 miles of usable range, this is a very, very compelling vehicle all the way around. And I am assuming at this point that the top trims will actually bring even more luxury and tech and niceties that surround me, because essentially this has the same powertrain that those models do. And again, it is, for all intents and purposes, the base model. Oh, squealing those tires. One more time. Good night. In a pickup truck. The real trick of this thing is the giggle pedal, because that's exactly what it is. You push it, you go, you giggle, you enjoy your time. The fact that you can pile anybody in the massive back seat of this thing, three across, no problem. This is starting to make me think it's the no compromise EV, especially starting at 40,000. Now let's go sample some of those top trims. This is the Lariat trim, and out of all the trims we have here to sample today, I do believe this is the one that would fit me, my family, my lifestyle, where we are right now. in every way but one major one, and that comes down to sticker shock and the $81,000 price tag on this particular model. It is very comfortable in here. It is very well appointed. It is very well put together. I like all of the materials. The ride is superb. I'm blown away by it. So you know, y'all have watched us for a while. We tested a $106,000 Lexus LX 600 F Sport on the channel. And I think this $80,000 Ford has as good, if not better, ride than that Lexus. So that's saying quite a bit about what Ford was able to do with this vehicle. It rides less like a truck than the regular F-150 does, and I think a lot of that has to do with the added weight of the batteries down between the frame rails down below us. So extra weight on what is already a very heavy vehicle down low, low center of gravity, helps take away some of that truck jitter that you normally get driving down railroad tracks like we're about to go down here in just a moment, brick streets, whatever the case may be. So this is a very well-riding pickup truck that rivals luxury cars twice the price of this. And I was blown away. That was perhaps my first like big takeaway from getting behind the wheel and getting some seat time here in the new F-150 Lightning, is just how smooth and quiet and comfortable the ride is. Just imagine getting a luxury car when you're shopping for this. But sitting behind the wheel in this one, driving it around historic downtown Grapevine, I am truly impressed with it, hands down. And then hopefully we'll get some highway time in this where I can really put the pedal down and see what this thing can do, taking advantage of all the electric vehicle aspects of it, the instant torque and the like there, because right now we're taking advantage of the weight. We're taking advantage of just how incredibly quiet it is. Got a ventilated seat right now. I'm nice and cool. Like, I could drive this home and be absolutely happy, keep it forever. Just don't come calling on me for the payments. No, thank you. Just not where we are at right now. But this does definitely make me question whether or not it is worth it, because I'm starting to get over that sticker shock just a little. The more I drive this, it's nice. You got this large color touchscreen display ripped straight out of the Ford Mustang Mach-E. So keeping the Ford EV stuff very similar. And, you know, we've had that vehicle. We took it to Amarillo and back. We've had some fun with it. So same basic setup here. And otherwise, just a really good riding truck. One advantage this Lightning has over the standard F-150 is the independent rear suspension. So this is the first full-size mainstream truck with an independent rear suspension. No live axle back there. I'm sure that, coupled with the low weight of the batteries, is also contributing to just how well this thing rides and how un-truck this thing rides. I am really impressed. Materials in here, you get this kind of blue jean denim look material on the dash and on the doors with some contrasting stitching. That is truly the best way to describe it. It looks like it wants to be denim. It's hard though, so it's very clearly not denim. Not quite sure what it is. Get this nice like textured bronze trim, which again feels like plastic, but also very nice. Just a quality interior here in this Lariat model, again, making it more the one I would want for my family, our life situation. It checks a lot of boxes. I'm sitting in a ventilated seat right now, three-person memory seat. I could not want for much more in this vehicle. And now I'm very excited that we are coming up on the highway, because we're gonna give this one a quick acceleration test. And I do believe in all literal sense. All right, so highway merge test. Hopefully all this traffic in front of us does not ruin the fun, because we have a very quick electric truck here on the road. I'm just gonna give them a little bit of runway and brace for impact, because here we go in 3, 2, 1. Good night. Oh my goodness. That is fun. All of the electric vehicle things translate here in this F-150 Lightning. It is the fastest F-150 Ford has ever made. And that traces all the way back to the original Lightning, which had a cult following in its own right. It definitely proves that Ford was onto something with the naming structure of this vehicle. You know, they just got lucky that they already had that Lightning in a bottle name to attach to this electric truck. But really, really fun vehicle out on the road. But that kind of stuff does get old after a little bit of time. How does it translate to everyday livability? Perfect. Gives you plenty of passing power for you just to get out and go. You don't have to wait on a transmission to downshift or anything like that. You can just go. Everything that we really like about electric vehicles here on the channel absolutely translates to this F-150 Lightning. Let's hop in a different trim now and see some of the differences and how they compare. Ready, set, holy crap. All right, so now we are in the top trim, platinum grade. It is very nice in here. Leather, all the things that were once that denim. More metal in here, which actually looks like real metal, kind of hard to tell. But very nice interior appointments in this one for sure. Very, very upscale interior in this platinum model. And then you get the very adjustable, very comfortable multi-position seats here that, like, so much going on here. And I'm sure if I go in here, let's see, turn on, that's the fan. There's a lot going on here too, but we've got ventilated seats, almost guaranteed to have massaging seats. Ah, there's the ventilation. Thank you, sir. Let's see, heated steering wheel. Ah, so much going on in this one. Make that smaller. There we go. Well, you get the gist of it. It is the same 15-inch screen that was in that Lariat model. This one is just a little more upscale and nice. We can see here, it didn't even talk about the digital gauge cluster in the last one. So if y'all followed the channel for a while, you know that we had a King Ranch model for a week's worth of testing that also had the digital gauge cluster. And in that one, I really wasn't the biggest fan, because it seems like Ford just leaned too hard into the digital aspect of things, and it just felt too forced or fake or just artificial. It makes a little more sense in the Lightning, because it's electric, it's the future, it's the here and now. So I don't know, it makes a little bit more sense in this vehicle to me. It's not as big of a gripe for me in this one. And it seems like they've updated it a little bit since then as well. I really like the left side of the screen here, because it is my range and my energy usage output. So I'm currently at 276 miles worth of range, which is plenty for even a Texas-sized road trip. That could take you anywhere you need to go, and would probably take you past the opportunity your bladder would take to speak up and say, hey, it's time to stop. So we are definitely in the era where range is not the problem that it used to be. And we're at a media event, so this vehicle is on a constant loop, constant drive. It's never really being turned off. Granted, sitting idle doesn't take as much power as you would think. It's It's actually moving this massive beast down the road that makes a difference to that energy usage. So all that saying, range anxiety, granted on this short media drive, it is not an issue, and very confident in what Ford was able to do with this F-150 Lightning. Now, being that it is a top platinum trim, it does cost a little bit more. So I've got the Monroney right here. Surprisingly, I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing. So the Lariat we were in, which was really well trimmed out, was 81. This one's 94. So I feel like that 81, you've already passed into that stratosphere of, I'm not quite sure I'm ready to pay that yet. So this one is definitely there at 94. But it's got some very nice features and aspects to it and is just as comfortable on the road. The ride on it is good, that independent rear suspension, the batteries being all that weight down low. Very, very good truck overall. Just personal opinions here. Not quite sure it's worth the premium over that Lariat if I were buying it for my family. Take that for what you will. I did see motorcycle cops, but whee! I have no idea. Okay, 40. Yeah, it's been a while since I've had to mess with. All right, so you push the vehicle, there we go. And then there's all the onboard scales. We didn't even talk about the onboard scales so that you actually know how much weight you're towing back there and the impact that it'll have on the towing. I think that is a truck feature that has been missing for a very long time. So that one's very interesting. Pro Power on board actually does have power under the hood in the frunk area. So you can actually have stuff powered up there. You can have a front tailgate, a rear tailgate, whatever you want to do. But there are those seat settings that we were looking for earlier with massage, absolutely turning that on, full recovery. This right here is why you'd want to get the Platinum because, you know, my lower back has been just a little bit of a problem here lately. This takes care of it. So going back to that Lexus LX600, sorry Lexus, not to throw shade, but if I'm in that price range, I am much more intrigued by this F-150 Lightning from Ford than I am the latest and greatest in SUV off-road luxury from Lexus. And that is saying a lot. And ooh, this massage seat, yes. That was a feature absolutely missing from that Lexus. Oh my goodness! the real life application of that speed, of that instant torque, truly is like this. It's merging into traffic. It's getting around the traffic that is in your way, that is causing a problem. Just making sure that you are not in a problem situation. It's fun, it makes me smile and laugh every time I do it, but the real perk, the real benefit to instantaneous torque, not having to worry about downshifting, which, if you remember our review of that King Ranch, that 10-speed was not the best. This takes all of that out of the equation and just allows you to go at will, and it's effortless speed. It almost hides the fact that this is a really, really big truck that is really heavy because it drives like a Mustang almost. Like it would put some Mustangs to shame because again, that instant power, that instant torque just truly makes a difference when driving this vehicle. This is what's interesting to me. So what are we're currently in normal, so we're not even in sport. Sport mode engaged. First person at a light. We'll get some onlookers for sure, but if you're ready, come on light, let's change. Oh my goodness. Whew. Yeah. Can I have this one? Like, My goodness. The F-150 is a family truck of Texas. It is the family vehicle of Texas. And with $4+ fuel prices, this just, it wipes that away. So what are you doing not getting this? All right, gearheads, that about does it for my time here with the Ford Lightning. I had so much fun driving these vehicles. It's truly amazing what Ford was able to do with this platform, and I am so excited. I have it on good authority. One will be coming to us for an extended test. So if you haven't already, be sure and hit that subscribe button, ring the bell so you're notified every time we post something new. Until next time, gearheads, bye. Yep. Okay, I'm talked in. I'm sold. All right, now for the fun part. I'll race that Raptor. Let's go. Yeah, thank you for ruining my. It's okay, we were both in the wrong spot.